Now, today we are going to discuss about the basics of the C programming, wherein the first chapter is on introduction to C language. So basically, the C program consisting of some structures. These structures have been divided or classified into comments, preprocessor directives, then global declarations, function declarations, then we have main, and with the open flower braces, you have a declaration section and the executable section. So first one, we are going to consider the comments and the programming style. Comment is a programming construct which contains the short description explaining the purpose of each statement or set of statements in a program. Basically, this is the reference which is given to a programmer who can write relevant to the program by writing in the statement. So that helps in, it is easy to read and understand the logic of the program. Suppose if you have written a program and if somebody has to look into that, then they will going to understand easily by looking at the statements which has been written in your program. And suppose if there is any modification has to be done, which has been written by somebody else, by looking at the logic of the program, by writing the statements on to this next to the next line, to the line, so we can able to modify easily. And it is a good programming style. Always the comment starts with friend slash star and end with star and friend slash. And it can appear anywhere in the program. And the next section, which will going to be the preprocessor directives. The preprocessor statements starts with the hash symbol, where hash include stdio.h, which is between the less than and greater than symbol. And also we can see the one more file, hash include math.h, which is also within less than and greater than symbol. Since it is a .h, it is an extension is .h, so obviously this should be a header file. And also using the preprocessor directives, the user can define the constants like hash define max 1024 if you want to define the global constants, and also hash define pi 3.1417. These are the, some of the examples. Then comes the global declarations and definitions. So what is the global declaration? The variables that are declared before all the functions are called the global declarations. What does it mean? So it means that it can be the global declaration or the global variables can be accessed by all the functions. As we declare the global variables, the functions are also declared here. Immediately after the functions are declared, the functions can be defined. Then comes the program header. The execution always starts from here, from this function, void main. It tells the compiler that execution always starts from the function main called the program header. Then the body of the program, a series of statements that perform a specific action, which will be enclosed within the braces of flower braces and present immediately after the program header, is called the body of the program. It contains the two essential parts. One is the declaration section and the other one is the execution section. So what is the declaration section? A variables that are used inside the function should be declared in the declaration section, in the sense that suppose if you have the three variables, if you are using, suppose for example, if I say the addition of the two numbers, so where we have A as the one number and B as the another number, then the sum is the another number, if you want, then it can be declared as the variables as int sum, int A semicolon, float B semicolon. This is how it can be declared. And also we can be able to initialize that value like int sum equals 0. This is just an example how we can initialize and also we can declare the variables. Then the executable section. It's the building block of a program. Instruction given to the computer to perform a specific task. So always the statement ends with the semicolon. So the statement can be the input or output statements, simple assignment statements, control statements such as if statement, for statement, while, do while, etc. Suppose if I want to write a small program, so I want to display the message C programming. How to write that program? It's a very simple program wherein hash include stdio.h, which is the header file for input and output statements, and the program starts with the header file main within brackets, small brackets, then open the flower bracket and printf within double quotes write C programming. This is the statement which ends with a semicolon here. You can see a semicolon here, and then close the flower braces, wherein you will be able to get the output as, if you run this program, finally the output will going to be written as C programming. This is how it will going to be executed. We are going to show this example in the other video. What are the steps to learn a C language? So exactly similar to the steps that we have followed to learn the natural language like English or Kannada or etc. So what are all these requirements? Like we can use alphabets like letters from capital A to Z or small a to Z. Then I can use digits like 0 to 9, and I can use symbols plus, minus, star, less than and greater than, etc. And then we have tokens like example keywords, for, if, int, float, etc. The variables like sum, area, first, marks, etc. Constants like 10, 10.5, minus 5.49. Statements or instructions. For example, suppose if I want to give a rate, suppose if I want to have the to find out the area, then area is equal to length into width. Then suppose if I want to find out the simple interest, ETR by 100. So these are the statements. Suppose if you want to write a small program for this, so wherein we have hash include stdio.h within greater than and less than symbol. Then we have void main and open the flower braces. Then we have the declaration of float function si, comma, we are going to initialize the values of ptr, p is equal to 1000, t is equal to 2 and r is equal to 5, and ends with a semicolon here. And then si is equal to ptr by 100 semicolon. So printf simple interest is equal to percentage d within double quotes comma si, and then the semicolon, and close the flower braces. So this is how we will be able to write a simple sample program. These are the basic steps which is required to learn a C language. And further explanations on the introduction of the C programming will be continued in our next video. Thank you.